Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Well, the Walker Lane Fault Zone, which is a new fault zone that will one day dominate over the San Andreas Fault Zone, has been very active today. So far, 25 earthquakes, the largest being a magnitude 3.6. 11 people have reported feeling that earthquake. It takes up about 25% of the North American plate motion, whereas the San Andreas Fault Zone takes up about 75%. Here you can see in this area where we have today's 3.6, there was also a 5.6, a 4.3, and not far from that earthquake in 2019 where they had the magnitude 7.1. The Walker Lane Fault Zone is a left lateral fault zone. It moves about 12 millimeters a year. So that's not even, a half an inch a year. And it runs into the Garlock Fault Zone, which has gotten a lot more active of late. The red lines that I have drawn out is the uplift that was caused by that 2019 7.1 earthquake. And this fault zone goes all the way up to Round Valley, Mono Lakes, Pyramid Lake, the Long Valley Caldera. Let me bring this in here. Maybe we can see some more names. And then over here we have Walker Lake and the Walker Lane Fault. I don't have that drawn out though. The Las Vegas Review Journal has an image of the Walker Lane divided up between the northern section and the southern section. The Walker Lane Fault Zone is about a million years younger than the San Andreas Fault Zone. Just like the San Andreas Fault Zone is divided up into different sections, and they say about every 20 to 30 years there's a major earthquake along the Walker Lane Fault Zone. You just don't know what part of it's going to happen. And earthquakes don't happen as they're supposed to by human predictions of scientists. But anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.